Hey guys, welcome back. In this video, I'm going to explain how to customize the default editor window of Angular Scheduler. Alright, you all might be aware of the default editor window, which gets opened while single clicking or double clicking the cells or events. So in this video, we'll see how to customize this particular editor window with our own required fields. For example, if you look onto any of the real-time applications that uses Scheduler, all those applications may want to use their own custom dialogs for adding or editing the appointments. This is because they need to add and display such additional fields and custom settings to match it with their application-specific scenarios. So to support such scenarios, Angular Scheduler comes with a built-in ability to customize the entire editor window so that the users can add their own custom fields. Here you can see the customized editor window with some limited fields like summary, status, from and to fields and the reason field. Now let's look on to an example on how to achieve this. So before starting with the example coding, let me tell you what components I'm going to use in this example. Like you can see here, I have used the dropdown component as well as the daytime picker. And before starting with the exact code, if you guys want to know about how to get started with the Angular Scheduler of Syncfusion and how to work with the appointments, please refer to my previous videos. Because in this video, I'm going to completely concentrate on the customization that can be done on the editor window of Angular Scheduler. So as I said before that I'm going to use the drop-down list and daytime pickers in this example. So first I need to install those packages in my application now. So for that, I need to install them with the command npm install at syncfusion/eg2-angular-dropdowns, as well as I also need to install another package which is eg2-angular-calendars. To directly start with the example, I have already installed these packages into my application. So now let's look on to the code directly. As I simply install the required components into my application, now I need to import them into the app.module.ts file. So within the app.module.ts file, I need to import the dropdown list module from EG to Angular dropdowns package, as well as I need to import the daytime picker module from EG to Angular calendars package. And also I need to include them within the imports array section as well. So all is done with the app.module.ts file. Now moving on to the app.component.ts file that is continued from my previous example. So here I'm gonna remove the e-views tag for better clarity of this example. I have defined the ng-template tag with the reference editor template and a template variable over here. So within this ng-template section, I'll place my custom design of editor window. And here you can see the table design within which I am going to place all the custom fields. So I have defined a first field over here, which is nothing but the subject field. And I have provided the label as summary for this. And here you can see I have assigned the data.subject value to the value property of input tag. So let's see about this a little bit later. So before that, I'll complete the design of the editor window first. And now another field, which is nothing but the status field. So I'll also describe this particular thing a little bit later. And now the other two fields for start time and end time. And finally a description field with the label reason. So this is how I designed the custom window now. Now let me tell you some mandatory things to be followed while designing such custom window. So whatever components you add into this particular ng template section, one thing you need to make sure that you must provide the e-field class name to all those components that you are using within this editor template option. And another thing, you need to define the data-name attribute for all the components. For these attributes, you should map the field names which you have provided within the scheduler data source. So you need to make sure that you have provided the proper e-field class name as well as the data-name attributes to all the components. So this is because the internal source processing is completely dependent upon these e-field class names as well as the data-name attributes. Other than these mandatory items, you can also specify other properties of components. Like here you can see for the drop-down list, I have defined the data source as well as some other properties. So let me show you how I have passed the data source for these drop-down list from the app component class. So here you can see how I have passed values to the status fields as well as the status data within the app component class. And I have assigned the respective variables to the appropriate properties of the component. And moving on to the next field, this is nothing but the start time field. So here I have already defined the e-field class name, and data name is mapped with start time field. And I have defined the format property to specify the datetime format. As I said earlier, that the values of appointment object are accessible within this template data. So there are two categories, that is cells and appointments. So when you double click on the cells, you'll be getting the start time values through this particular variable start time. And at the same time, when you double click on the appointments, you'll be able to access the start time value with this data.startTime field name, which is bound to the scheduler data source. So we are simply differentiating the data that are being accessed within this template through this different variables over here. So in the same way, the endTime field has also been defined in the same way. So this DateParser method, I need to define it manually within this app component class for proper DateTime conversion before the DateTime values are being assigned to the StartTime and EndTime fields. So for that purpose, you can see I have defined the DateParser method over here, which accepts the date string and converts it to the DateTime format. And next comes the description field. So here I am simply assigning the data.description to the value property of text area. And one more condition I have added within this ng template, where the data should not be an undefined value. So that's all about the changes that we are done with the editor window customization. So we have simply defined the ng template design over here with the required fields, and also provided the data source for the status field within the app component class, and also included the e-field class names to all the components as well as data-name attributes as well. So I'm saving my application now. To see the difference, I'm double clicking on the cells within the 12 p.m. time slot, and here you can see the start time field and the end time field directly filling up with the correct time ranges. And if I give some summary text and status and some reason and simply save my appointment, you can see the appointment getting added to the exact time range which I have chosen. So if I double click on this particular appointment, you can see the items are directly filling over on each of the components. So these are the two scenarios we have covered within the editor template option. And one more thing I'll show from here, that if you want to change the title of the appointment window, which is new event by default, and also the save and cancel option text, you can pass the required text to the locale collection. So let's see how to do it in the code. So for this, I need to import the L10N class from the EJ2 base package. And then I need to make a call to the load function of L10N class, so within which I have accessed the locale words of scheduler. So for the save button, I have provided the replacement text as add, for cancel button as close, for delete button as remove, and for the title of the appointment window, new event, as add event. So I'm saving this now. Now when I double click on the cells or appointments, you can notice that the new event has been changed to add event, and the save has been changed as add, and the cancel is being showed as close over here. And in the same way, when I double click on the appointments, you can see now that the delete option has been changed to remove text. There are furthermore locale words you can change for the scheduler strings. For that, you can refer the documentation page of the Angular scheduler, which I'll share at the end of this video. And there are much more things you can do with this editor window customization. For all those topics, you can refer the detailed documentation page of Angular Scheduler. So in this video, we have seen how to customize the editor window with our own custom design. And I hope you might be surprised with the simple lines of code used for this customization purpose. So please try this out in your application and let me know if you have any further clarification in this particular topic in the comment section. And also, if you find this video as useful, give it a like and subscribe to our channel as well. And also keep on watching my next video as well, on which I am going to cover how to customize the header rows of timeline scheduler views. Thank you.